This is the OTB Television Network, a service of Capital District Off-Track Betting.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses as we took a look at the Independence Day weekend. Outstanding racing, not only around the United States, but the annual biggest day of the year up at Woodbine. But we're going to kick it off the Summit of the Speed down at Gulfstream Park. Up first, the Carryback.
They're all in the gate. And they're off in the Carryback Stakes. From the rail, Awesome Banner begins nicely, and from the outside, Discreet Angel is away in good shape. These two are quickest. Settling down third is Dream of Me, followed by Lil Meatball in fourth. It's a stretch of four to Jacopone, then Bullet Gone Astray, and the Kentucky Invader Rated R Superstar is last of the seven and about seven lengths off the speed of Awesome Banner. It's Awesome Banner and Tyler Gaffleone in front by a length. Discreet Angel is there second. Dream of Me is backed off to race in third, two off the leader. Back and forth is Lil Meatball, then it's a stretch of six to Rated R Superstar, who's a length and a half in front of Bullet Gone Astray, and Jacopone is the trailer. They move into the far turn after completing a quarter in 22 and one. At 2-5, Awesome Banner, the one to beat. Discreet Angel stays with him from second, 2.5 lengths to Lil Meatball in third. Then it's Dream of Me from fourth. Rated R Superstar trying to get underway from fifth now. Then comes Bullet Gone Astray as they pass the quarter mile pole. Awesome Banner maintains control through a 44 2/2 mile. Set down for the drive by Tyler Gaffleone and leading it by three. Up into second is Rated R Superstar, back third Discreet Angel. There's an eighth of a mile to go. Awesome Banner digging in. Rated R Superstar drawing up alongside on the outside. Here comes Rated R Superstar and Awesome Banner. It's going to be close. Rated R Superstar surging to the lead. Rated R Superstar edges in front. Second is Awesome Banner. Third is Bullet Gone Astray. Then Dream of Me and Discreet Angel and 122 flat.
Rated R Superstar, ladies and gentlemen, wins by 3/4 length. Second choice in the wagering turns $7.40 for Cornelio Velasquez, who's moved his tack successfully down to South Florida. Ken McPeak sends out the winner. They defeat the 2-5 favorite, Awesome Banner. Bullet Gone Astray finishes third, checking out that 7 for a long time, 122.09. We'll see that in just a moment again. But now we're going to go to 6 furlongs. We have 3-year-olds and up in the Smile.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Smile Sprint. From the center, Chief Lion wins the start, but quickly up to take over is Delta Bluesman. And Delta Bluesman leads 3/4 of a length early from Chief Lion, who's kept him a close early second. From Limousine Liberal, who gets a good setup early, he's third. Then it's 83 in Storm and Inti, followed by Coping Away. And More Applause is last as they speed to the half-mile pole. Toward the inside, Delta Bluesman leads narrowly. And Manuel Esquivel turning up the pressure with Chief Lion on his outside. They've opened 3 now on Luis Saez and Limousine Liberal, who've racing in third. These top three have put 6 on 83, then Storm and Inti and Coping Away, and More Applause is the trailer. They drilled a quarter in 21 3. There's less than 5/16 to go. On top, Chief Lion. The whip is out now on Delta Bluesman from second. 2.5 back to Limousine Liberal. He pins his ears 3 wide through an opening half mile in 43 4. 3/16 to go on the Smile. Chief Lion, Delta Bluesman battles back, and Delta Bluesman just took the lead again. Back to second is Chief Lion, then Limousine Liberal. Late run from 83, but it's Delta Bluesman, super in the Smile to win it. Gate to wire by 2.5. Close then for second, Limousine Liberal or Chief Lion. 83 finished fourth in 108 4.
Delta Bluesman, ladies and gentlemen, 43 and change, 108.94. Jorge Navarro's runner wins by 3 3/4 lengths as the slight second choice in the wager, returning $5 even. Limousine Liberal, the 7-5 betting favorite, finishes second. Chief Lion finishes third in the Smile. And now annually, one of the more prestigious Philly and Mare sprint races. Unfortunately, it lost its grade one status 2 years ago. The Princess Rooney.
And they're off in the Princess Rooney Stakes. Good beginning outside for Spelling again from the center. Here are the Grays, My Miss Venezuela, and Concealed with a Kiss to go on with it. Willow Hills now comes on to be third from Spelling again, who's back fourth. Then it's Cali Star with Be Mine Phil and the Pink on her outside. Second last is Kiss to Remember, and the favorite Bird at the Wire will have to do it from last. She's about six lengths off the lead of My Miss Venezuela. It's My Miss Venezuela through an opening quarter in 22-2, leads it by almost 2.5 now. Second is Concealed with a Kiss. Willow Hills is third, Spelling again in the clear on the outside. Then comes Cali Star with Be Mine Phil and Kiss to Remember, and not asked for much yet. Bird at the Wire is last while tipping into the clear to start a rally as they run around the far turn. There's 3 furlongs to go in the Princess Rooney. My Miss Venezuela has the lead. Jaramillo launching Kiss to Remember 4 wide. That forces Saez's hand on Spelling again, and she moves right with her. Meanwhile, Gaffney Lone has Bird at the Wire in full gear. She's in the third now as they run past the quarter mile pole. On the inside, Spelling again has a head in front. Kiss to Remember right alongside second, and Bird at the Wire has momentum down the center with Cali Star fourth. There's an 1/8 of a mile to go. Spelling again digging in gamely down the outside. Cali Star and Bird at the Wire, 16th pole. Cali Star really rolling. This is going to get close. Cali Star at Spelling again. Here's the wire. It's a photo finish. Photo finish in the Princess Rooney. Spelling again inside. Cali Star on the outside in 122 flat.
And just as like the carry back, 122.09 for the winner's running time. Luis Saez aboard Spelling again. They score the victory, returning $8.80 sent out by Brad Cox. Cali Star finishes second. The even money favorite, Bird at the Wire, finishes third in the Princess Rooney. Independence Day over at Parks. We have the Dr. James Penny Memorial.
And they're off in the Doc Penny Memorial. And Keystone Kelly comes bouncing right out of there. Zepessa shows speed. Tammy the Torpedo will take back. She's sitting third here early on the inside. Tutu Paisi moving up outside to be fourth with Tiger Ride in a bit tight there. Passed on the inside by Devil Went to Georgia. And Serious Happiness will trail as they head toward that first turn. So Zepessa leads the way. The first quarter mile is up in 24-1 for Zepessa. She's on top now by just over a length. Tammy the Torpedo sitting down inside second. Keystone Kelly is on the outside. She's now racing third by a length and a half. Tutu Paisi has settled nicely into the fourth spot. As they move to the back stretch, she's about 3.5 lengths off the lead. Another length and a half to Devil Went to Georgia. Tiger Ride toward the back. She's just better than 5 back right now. A gap of 5 more to Serious Happiness. The half mile was very comfortable, 48-3. So Zepessa, midway up the back stretch, controls the pace. She's on top by just over a length. Javier Castellano has edged Tammy the Torpedo into the clear on the outside. She continues to give chase second. Tutu Paisi is improving her position. She's on the inside, moving up third. On the outside, here comes Devil Went to Georgia. 35-1 shot up into contention with a bit on the outside. Tutu Paisi still covered up at the inside. Tiger Ride begins to get on track. She's still 4 back and in behind horses. As they hit the top of the stretch, it is Zepessa. Zepessa comes off the turn and kicks away to a 2.5 length lead. There's room inside now for Tutu Paisi. She's coming on second. Tammy the Torpedo did not go on. Tiger Ride on the outside, but it is Zepessa. A beautiful judged ride here by Florent Giroux today. And Zepessa goes gate to wire, and she wins it by 2.5 lengths. Tutu Paisi was second. Tiger Ride was up for third.
Florent Giroux, ladies and gentlemen, having an outstanding last 2 years. He wins a stakes race with a third choice on the wagering. The offspring is City Zip, who we have come to know as a terrific turf stallion. Remember a couple years ago, 2 winners on the Breeders' Cup card. But $7.40 for the 2 length every step of the way winner. Tutu Paisi, ridden by Chris DiCarlo, the second choice, finishes second. Tiger Ride finishes third. Tammy the Torpedo, with Javier Castellano on the saddle at 8-5, finishes fourth in the Dr. James Penny Memorial. Monmouth Park for a couple stakes races over the weekend. Up first, on the dirt, going a mile, the Salvatore.
And they're off in the Salvatore Mile, and Res Judicata wastes no time sprinting to the front. Nona's Boy has some speed. Allied Air Raid is third on the outside, and Mr. Jordan, those two in very close quarters around the first turn. Where it's Res Judicata with a narrow advantage, Nona's boy in a tight spot has to take back now, and Mr. Jordan inches up outside of him to take second. That leaves Allied Air Raid at the back of the pack. 2.5 lengths covers the field, making their way onto the backstretch. It's Res Judicata leading by 3/4 of a length. Mr. Jordan is in second. Nona's boy side by side with Allied Air Raid. Very compact, heading to the half-mile pole in the Salvator Mile. And it's Res Judicata carving out the fractions, opens it up again to a length and a half on Mr. Jordan second. Nona's boy holding his own at the rail in third, and Allied Air Raid is inching up. Now he's making his move 3 furlongs from home. Res Judicata has been there every step of the way. Mr. Jordan, Allied Air Raid moves up to take second. Nona's boy is now last, but still only 2.5 lengths covers the field. They're 1/4 mile from home. Res Judicata is trying to sprint for home and pull off the upset. He's got something left, and he has a 3-length lead. Mr. Jordan didn't fire. Down at the rail, it's Nona's boy and Allied Air Raid, but they are all running for minor awards in the final furlong. Res Judicata making short work of the Salvator Mile field under Nick Juarez. A dominant front-running score. Res Judicata by 4 lengths. Allied Air Raid second. Mr. Jordan third. Nona's boy was fourth.
Nick Juarez, John Service, every step a winning one for the offspring of Smarty Jones. The longest shot in the board, field of 4. This was the 8-1 shot, wins by 3.75, returns $18 even. Allied Air Raid finishes second, and the 4-5 favorite, Mr. Jordan, beats one horse by finishing third in the Salvator Mile. Sunday afternoon, one of the big races annually down at Monmouth Park, 1 3/8 on the turf, the Grade 1 United Nations.
And they're off in the United Nations, and Triple Threat just walked out of the gate. Cement Clement wins the start. World Approval has some early speed. Riviere de Loup on the far outside, and Noble Road came away in the top flight as well. The pace is swift early on. Money Multiplier, fifth, already 8 or 9 lengths off the pacemaker. Can't Help Believing is racing on the inside. A bigger picture than Mr. Maybe. Wake Forest is second to last, and slow starting Triple Threat is at the back of the pack. Into the stretch for the first time, and it's Cement Clement leading it by 2.5 lengths, trying to slow things down after a quick opening quarter. World Approval is in second. He's got 2.5 lengths to make up. And Money Multiplier now also cutting into the margin with Noble Road on the fence in fourth. Riviere de Loup is racing in mid-pack. Bigger Picture is just outside of him. Can't Help Believing rides the rail. He's inside the favorite Wake Forest and 8 lengths off the lead. 2 more back to Mr. Maybe and Triple Threat. They have 6 furlongs to run, and it's Cement Clement leading it by 2 lengths. World Approval is in second. Money Multiplier and Noble Road side by side, third and fourth. Bigger Picture takes fifth, 7 lengths off the lead. Riviere de Loup is next. Can't Help Believing, 1 from the rail in the yellow cap. And now Wake Forest is starting to find his best ride. He's on the move, taking fifth with 1/2 mile left to go. Triple Threat is out of last. Mr. Maybe can see them all. Into the far turn, Cement Clement still there by 1.5 lengths. World Approval is coming after him and cutting into that margin with each and every stride now. Second, Money Multiplier, third. Noble Road is losing a bit of ground. Fourth, Wake Forest, fifth. Riviere de Loup between horses. Triple Threat followed by Can't Help Believing, who's in traffic. And Mr. Maybe is starting to wind up. He's coming on the far outside. World Approval takes the lead at the top of the stretch. Triple Threat is finishing with interest. Money Multiplier is running a giant one. He's currently in second. And Wake Forest is also finishing well, but it's World Approval doing the best work. And World Approval and Florent Giroux, a dominating win in the United Nations. Second goes to Money Multiplier. Then it was Wake Forest in third. Fourth between Triple Threat and Can't Help Believing.
World Approval, a brilliant, brilliant performance by not only horse, but jockey Florent Giroux over a good turf course, scores the victory as second choice in the wagering. Mark Cassie, who has it going very well this year, sends out the winner. World Approval returns $7.40. Money Multiplier finishes second. And the 9-5 favorite, Wake Forest, little trouble in the lane, finishes third in this UN. this year's UN, I should say. No longer a handicap, unfortunately. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, a terrific 3 days of racing at Woodbine.
Come on.
I want sales reports on my desk by Monday.
Whoops. My bad.
Love racing? RTN brings you every live simulcast on your home television, plus live video streaming and race replays on your PC and mobile devices. To order, visit RTN.tv. RTN, a breed apart.
Jack Angelucci on the outside, Ali Chiba. Ferdinand has the lead. Ali Chiba, a final surge. The two Derby winners hit the wire together. Ferdinand and Ali Chiba in a dramatic photo finish.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to north of the border, Woodbine Racetrack. Friday afternoon was Dominion Day in Canada. So the mile and a quarter, Dominion Day stakes.
Off and racing in the Dominion Day, and back to the tail, Scuba, Red Rifle, the inside. Going out in front, War Dancer, and not much pace being shown here. War Dancer out in front of Breaking Lucky, and on the outside, Melmich, content to be off their flank. Up the rails, Red Rifle, and the gray in the center is Scuba. War Dancer with a measured stride down the stretch the first time in front. Up the rails, Red Rifle on the outside, Breaking Lucky, the trio by a length to Scuba, settling better. And on the outside is Melmich, only three lengths covers them. And Red Rifle comes up on the inside as they work their way out the stretch. It's Red Rifle and War Dancer at the top two, Breaking Lucky the outside, on the heels of the leader Scuba, and Melmich is last. Opening quarter was a slow one, 25-1, and War Dancer and Red Rifle have been the top two throughout, and it's on the outside, War Dancer a neck in front. A length and a half to Breaking Lucky is lying third, on the inside is Scuba and Wonder Melmich at the back. Still only four lengths, first to last, the half mile, 49-2, and War Dancer by a half a length, Red Rifle, who continues to hold the inside as they go inside the 5/8. Breaking Lucky stalks in third, Scuba under a tight rein. One away last is Melmich, and no moves yet. Red Rifle pinching ground on the inside has come through to share that lead. And as they go inside the final half mile, neck and neck, War Dancer, Red Rifle. One to Breaking Lucky. On the inside, Scuba's traveled okay, and last is Melmich. Red Rifle stretches the neck out and goes clear. Red Rifle in front. War Dancer comes fighting right back, and then nip and tuck. Breaking Lucky called on now, and on the inside, Scuba trying to get the run. Melmich and Eureka Rosa da Silva take off from the back, and this is a totally different game plan. Oh, coming from last, Melmich race past the top two, now has to contend with Breaking Lucky and Scuba, and Melmich in front in the Dominion Day, and Melmich by a length to Breaking Lucky. Breaking Lucky has a 16th to try and pick up Melmich, but it's a forlorn task, and Melmich, what a great plan, from the back, has won the Dominion Day by a length and a half. Breaking Lucky second, third was Scuba. War Dancer next, and Red Rifle was last.
Melmich scores the victory from last to first. The favorite at 2-1. Heck, the long shot finished third at 6-1. Scores the victory, Kevin Attard, ridden by Enrique Rosa da Silva. They returned $6 even for the length and a half victory. Breaking Lucky finishes second. Scuba finishes third. The favorite wins by a length and a half. The offspring of Wilco. 204.06 on the Tapita. Not too bad. All right, over to the turf on Saturday afternoon. the 114th running of the King Edward.
Racing in the King Eddie to a perfect start. And away very nicely, Tower of Texas. Going up in front, though, Hammerstein from Smoke'em Kitten. They're the top two. A length to Solemn Tribute lying in third. Up the rail, Commute joins the fray up front. And tracked along by Full Mast, who's about three off the lead. A half a length, Tessa on the grey. Two length, Dimension, second last. And dipping to last early now, Tower of Texas. Racing with the lead is Hammerstein. And up the inside is still Smoke'em Kitten, who's scraping the hedge a half away. Now pushing for the lead. One away is Solemn Tribute, stalks the pair. Commute on the inside, Full Mast under a tight rein in the center, and they're bunched right up. Then Tesseron, one to Tower of Texas, and last is Dimension. Racing along towards the half mile and showing out narrowly, Hammerstein up the inside, Smoke'em Kitten, and pacing along with them, Solemn Tribute, and they go through the half mile. That top trio with about a length and a half to spare. Full Mast is next. On the inside, Commute, three wide, Tesseron. Dimension called on is running on pretty well, and two and a half to Tower of Texas as they come down towards the home stretch, and Smoke'em Kitten the inside, Hammerstein the center, three wide, Solemn Tribute, looking for room, Full Mast, up the rail, Commute and Dimension down the outside, Tower of Texas winding up, many chances, but Solemn Tribute and Dimension have gone to the front, a Dimension on the outside, made an early jump on them, now Full Mast is called on and Tower of Texas, but Dimension, it was no fluke last time, and Dimension's getting the hang of this turf track all right, Dimension powering on, Tower of Texas giving chase, Solemn Tribute on the inside, but Dimension has gone on to take another stakes victory. This time the King Eddie, second on the inside, Solemn Tribute, then Tower of Texas, and Full Mast was fourth.
Dimension back early at 17-1. The third longest shot on the board scores the huge upset victory, $37.10. Solemn Tribute finishes second. Tower of Texas finishes third, and Full Mast, who was so impressive in New York, the United States debut, was the even money favorite as in the second start in the United States, can do no better than fourth in Saturday's King Edward. All right, four stakes races to bring you from Sunday afternoon. Up first, the Highlander.
Off and racing and coming out the best, Something Extra, Lady Shipman. Right up on the inside, Lady Shipman second, a length away third, moving into it quickly. Green Mask has gone up on the outside of the filly, and a length away came Black Hornet, Hootenanny, and last is Passion for Action. But Joel Rosario switches off the inside and goes up to challenge. It's Something Extra from Lady Shipman, who's a neck away second, and now settling with the drop on them nicely is Green Mask, a length away third. A break of three lengths away, the others, Black Hornet, Hootenanny, and Passion for Action on the inside. They've gone through the first quarter briskly and out in front. It remains Something Extra by a long neck to Lady Shipman. Right behind, waiting in the wings, is Green Mask as they come for the lane in the Highlander. And Lady Shipman tightening the screws now on Something Extra. Green Mask down the outside. It's Lady Shipman going up to share the lead. Down the outside, Green Mask, Passion for Action running on. On the outside, Green Mask tackling Lady Shipman. And down the outside, Passion for Action. Something Extra's there. But Green Mask has got the measure of Lady Shipman. Passion for Action's getting them all. Passion for Action right over the top. Passion for Action hit the front, and Passion for Action in front has won the Highlander Stakes a neck. Green Mask second, two and a half Something Extra behind them, Lady Shipman, Hootenanny, and last Black Hornet.
Passion for Action. Enrique Rosa da Silva scores the victory, returning the upset, winning the photo finish. Returns $15.30 for the offspring of Spicetown. Finishing second is Green Mask. Something Extra finishes third, and Lady Shipman, who has put together a sensational last 12 months at 1-2, finishes fifth in the Highlander. Up next, the 13th running of the mile and a half Singspiel.
Away in racing and coming out the best, Mr. Grumpy. A good beginning, Money Talker. They're the top two early. Amiz Holiday got out smartly. Up the inside is Alduous Snow and Danish Dynaformer as they work their way down the stretch the first time. Hardest Course on the outside. And back to the tail end early is Generous Kitten as they start the climb up the hill. And racing with the advantage is Money Talker. Money Talker by one. Going to second is Hardest Core. Lying third, Mr. Grumpy. Danish Dinoformer is next. Tucked up is Alder Snow on the inside. Back second last, Generous Kitten. And last is Amiz Holiday as they work their way into the backstretch. Rounding that turn, Money Talker has really cracked out a little bit of a faster pace now. Opens up to lead by about two or three lengths. Lying second, Hardest Core, they're six in front. Mr. Grumpy is third. A length and a half, Danish Dinoformer, followed by Alduis Snow. Generous Kitten is back second last. And four lengths away last is Amiz Holiday. Trying to break free here, and doing so are Money Talker and Hardest Core. Hardest Core and Emma Jane Wilson tracking well as they work their way down the backstretch. Six away, third, Mr. Grumpy from Danish Dinoformer. Alduis Snow on the inside. Two to Generous Kitten. And six away last is Amiz Holiday. The half 51 and 2, and out in front, it is still a length and a half lead to Money Talker. Lying second, Hardest Core. Now the brigade coming on a little bit. Four lengths to Mr. Grumpy. And Eureka Rosa de Silva getting Alduis Snow to run up the inside. Danish Dinoformers three wide. One to Generous Kittens, traveled easily. And last is Amiz Holiday. They start the run down towards the half mile. And it's Money Talker in front. Hardest Core second. Lying third is Mr. Grumpy. Danish Dinoformer is moving up. Two lengths away, Alduis Snow. Generous Kitten on the outside, winding up for Julien Leparu. And last is Amiz Holiday. They hit the three furlong peg and still in front. Money Talker by one. Hardest Core second. A length and a half, Danish Dinoformer. Up in the center, Alduis Snow. Generous Kitten the outside. And on the rails, Mr. Grumpy. Last Amiz Holiday. Hardest Core after Money Talker. Down the outside, Danish Dinoformer. Generous Kitten in behind them. They run down towards the final furlong and a half. And Danish Dinoformers come up to hit the front. And Danish Dinoformer back to Woodbine with a vengeance. Danish Dinoformer in the Singspiel clearing off. Down the outside, Generous Kitten. But it's Danish Dinoformer in front. And Danish Dinoformer has won it. Hardest Core second, Alduis Snow third. Behind them, Generous Kitten. And on the inside, Money Talker.
Danish Dinoformer scores the victory for Roger Atfield and Pat Husbands. I think Danish Dinoformer might have been about 5 or 6 to 1 on the morning line. There were no scratches. Goes off as the 9 to 5 favorite, which we sort of thought might happen. Wins by a length, returns $5.80. Hardest Score finishes second. Aldous Snow finishes third in this year's Singspiel. Up next, Phillies and Mariners on the turf, named after the Hall of Famer, the Dance Smartly.
Racing in the Dance Smartly, a great start. A good beginning, Nakuti and Uchenna. And coming through in the center is the Teacups. And taking up the run is Lexi Liu on the inside. Has come up to share the advantage with Goodyear for Roses to second. Right behind them goes Secret Action, who's in the thick of things with on the inside Ball Dancing. Strut the course, parked behind the main bunch, and a length away Uchenna. One away is Heath on the inside, who's third last. Next to last, Industrial Policy. And the early trailer is Season Ticket. And the 2014 Queen's Plate winners out in front, doing very nicely here. Lexi Liu. Lexi Liu left alone, racing out by four lengths. Lying second, Goodyear for Roses on the inside of the Teacups. A length away came Secret Action. Nakuti taking closer order from Strut the Course. On the inside is Ball Dancing. They're out by two to Heath, getting up on the inside of Uchenna. Back second last, Industrial Policy. And last is Season Ticket. They swing off to the half mile, and look at Lexi Liu just loving this. Lexi Liu six in front. Goodyear for Roses, the Teacup second and third. A break to Nakuti. Up the inside is still Secret Action. Now Strut the Course starting to wind up. Three lengths away is Uchenna. On the inside is Ball Dancing, and behind them Industrial Policy running now. Second last as they turn is Heath, and last Season Ticket. Top of the lane in the Dance Smartly. Lexi Liu in front. Coming fast, Nakuti and Strut the Course. And Strut the Course at the girth of Lexi Liu. Nakuti the center. Down the outside, Ball Dancing running on, and so too Uchenna. Three across the track. Nakuti just in front. On the outside, Strut the Course. Battling away Lexi Liu. And down the outside, Uchenna. It is Nakuti, and Lexi Liu fights right back. And flying late is Heath. Lexi Liu's going to do it. Yes, she has. Wow, she's terrific. Lexi Liu first. Strut the Course in the photo with her weakening Nakuti. And on the inside was Heath.
Lexi Liu, winner of the Queen's Plate a couple of years ago, goes to the front under Pat Husbands and makes every call for Mark Cassie. Second choice in the wager returns $8.60. Strut the Course, the 2-1 favorite, finishes second, winning the 5-horse photo finish for second. And Jose Ortiz aboard the third place finisher. But Lexi Liu bouncing back on the undercard of the Queen's Plate to win the Dance Smartly. Up next, the 157th running of the Queen's Plate.
Racing in the Queen's Plate. Leave Him in Malibu got squeezed a little bit. Chebarashka best into stride with Esposito. And showing early speed, Shakamat. Sir Dudley digs on the inside. The gray, My Name is Jim, is handy. And on the rails, Narrow Escape. And in behind them early is Amiz Gizmo, who's about 4 off the pace. Up on the inside early is Mike. And the pace is very measured as Shakamat's gone to the front. Racing back in the center is All On Red on the outside. Scholar Athletes third or fourth last with Rocket Plan. Gambles goes to second last. And Leave Him in Malibu is last. A different game plan today by Emma Jane Wilson, and it's Take Them All the Way If We Can. Shakamat in front leads in the Queen's Plate out the stretch and leads by one. Chebarashka second. Narrow Escape on the inside. Handy Esposito but caught a little bit wide. Sir Dudley digs the center. Crying out for room is Mike, and around them now goes Amiz Gizmo. My Name is Jim is mid-pack. Three parts to Scholar Athlete. Patrick Husbands is next on Gamble's Ghost. Then Rocket Plan, All On Red starting to move into it, and Leave Him in Malibu the outside. The half was 49-4, and they're playing right into the hands of Shakamat here. Shakamat by one. Esposito's gone to second, and Amiz Gizmo's right handy now. And back to fourth, Chebarashka. Sir Dudley Diggs called on off the track, My Name is Jim. Scholar Athlete splits horses as they head towards the far turn. Off the track, All On Red's under the whip at making ground. On the inside, Narrow Escape. Now Gamble's Ghost asked to run. As on the outside, Amiz Gizmo's going to the front with Shakamat. Leave Him in Malibu's back. Fourth last from Mike. Rocket Plan's at the back. They race to the quarter, and Amiz Gizmo's gone on by Shakamat. Is able to come back a little bit, Shakamat. And running home well are Sir Dudley Dick, Scholar Athlete, then Esposito. Top of the lead in the Queen's Plate. And Amiz Gizmo trying to tear away. Shakamat on the inside. Down the outer is Sir Dudley Diggs. Sir Dudley Diggs the threat. Amiz Gizmo in front, but here comes Sir Dudley Diggs and Julien Leparoux. Sir Dudley Diggs has hit the front, and Sir Dudley Diggs from Amiz Gizmo. Sir Dudley Diggs has won the Queen's Plate. Amiz Gizmo second, All On Red third, and Scholar Athlete fourth.
First time over the Tapita in a very exciting stretch run is Sir Dudley Diggs in the familiar silks of the Ramsey, burst through under Julien Leparoux at nearly 16-1. The offspring of Gio Ponte returns $33.90, defeating the 5-2 favorite. All On Red finishes third in this year's renewal of the Queen's Plate. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, closing day at Churchill Downs, and three nights at Prairie Meadows.
Now get all the racing information you need right on your mobile device with Capital OTB's new mobile app. Wager anytime, anywhere, right from your smartphone or tablet. Watch, wager, and win right at your fingertips. The new Capital OTB mobile app.
Pick, bet, and cheer on world-class horse racing from Woodbine and Mohawk Racetracks. Over 130 live thoroughbred days, over 200 live harness days, loads of action, tons of bet types. The guaranteed pick four, jackpot high five, and pick six bets are just the beginning. Join the ranks of Woodbine and Mohawk players from all over the globe and make your bets count. For more information on the latest updates on events and offers, visit woodbineentertainment.com.
To go. Gunrunner, Exaggerator on the outside. Nyquist and Exaggerator, they're coming to the line together. And Nyquist is still unbeaten. He has won the Kentucky Derby.
In a recent study of some of the top online wagering sites, Capital OTB won big in total player rewards, far surpassing some of the best-known wagering sites in America. While other rewards programs simply offer you points redeemable for gift cards, Capital OTB's rebates are paid to you in actual cash. Plus, Capital OTB gives you full and immediate access to your money. So if all you're getting now are points and gift cards, join Capital OTB Player Rewards today and get cash back. Visit CapitalOTBBet.com and sign up today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to closing day at Churchill Downs. Up first, the 2-year-old fillies and the debutante.
And they're off. Like a Hurricane for the far outside is out well, but Country Candy quicker toward the inside. Those two go on with it, with Tricky One not far behind, pulling back to be third in the early going. Out of the outside, it's China Grove, who races up to be fourth by two. Whole Scoop is running along in fifth. Grandma's Princess, sixth toward the rail. Pretty Seated Dancer comes on seventh. Maximum Edge on the far outside is eighth. Silver Threads comes through toward the rail in ninth. Anna's Bandit is at the back of the pack, racing by the half-mile pole like a Hurricane. Onto the far turn in front by one, but Tricky One in pursuit just a length behind as they round the turn together. 21-3 was the quarter. Three furlongs to go. Like a Hurricane in front. Tricky One on the outside right there running along in second. Pretty Seated Answers winding up fifth, fourth, now third, coming on the far outside. And Silver Threads is following her around the far turn. Things changing quickly. They're off the turn now. Tricky One, Pretty Seated Answer. Pretty Seated Answers off the turn in front. And from the back of the pack, Anna's Bandit's putting in a late bid. Maximum Edge on the far outside. There's one furlong left. Pretty City Dancer driving on a two-length lead. Country Candy down inside hanging in there. Anna's Bandit's Tricky One. Everyone else is giving chase to Pretty City Dancer to win the debutante by three in the end. Anna's Bandit was second. Country Candy was third. And Tricky One was fourth.
Pretty City Dancer, the offspring of Tap It wins from Mark Cassie and John Oxley. Julian Leperoux aboard. They return $9.66. Anna's Bandit finishes second. Country Candy finishes third. The 3-1 favorite, China Grove, finishes eighth in this year's debutante. Up next, the 2-year-old boys going sixth in the Bashford Manor.
And they're off. And recruiting ready, off to a rocket start, just like that, clear by one. U.S. Officer comes away well, Riv is there too, and toward the inside, Tip Tap Tap is our showing some speed as they head up the backstretch. It's recruiting ready in front on the far outside. Tip Tap Tap is our comes on through to be second in the early going. Riv is right there too, racing third by three. Raising Room is out in fourth, U.S. Officer fifth, Captain Grider sixth. Classic Empire up into seventh on the outside of Boys from Boston, and a ways back to My Golden Aura at the back of the pack, racing onto the far turn. The quarter was 21-3, and recruiting ready steps on it now. Opens up a length and a half with three furlongs to go. Tip Tap Tap is our in pursuit second. Riv is under pressure third on the outside. Four lengths back to Raising Rumors. Classic Empire is going to come through, and that one's inside as they hit the top of the stretch. It's recruiting ready in front. Tip Tap Tap is our coming with a challenge, though. A length and a half behind, and Classic Empire has moved in to be third as they head for the final furlong. But recruiting ready turns back. Tip Tap Tap is our is going to have to fend off Classic Empire, who's coming with a bold late bid with a 16th to go. Recruiting ready by two. Classic Empire a length behind, half a length. Now he's ahead. Now he's in front. Classic Empire nails recruiting ready on the wire. Tip Tap Tap is our was third, and Boys from Boston was fourth.
Mark Cassie, John Oxley, Julian Leperoux. No, it's not a broken record. This is the offspring of Pioneer of the Nile, Classic Empire. Wins by 3/4 of a length, returning $11.40. Defeating the 1-2 favorite recruiting ready, Tip Tap Tapazar finishes third. Folks, these were the only three horses less than 5-1. The next horse was 13-1. They bet the right three, but Classic Empire wins the Bashford Manor. Turning our attention to Prairie Meadows on Thursday evening, the Iowa Oaks.
Off and running in the Iowa Oaks. So it's Family Tree from the outside, and Marquis Miss, the first two away, Put the Blame on Me, and Thrilled is right there as well. Then comes a Ready to Confess, Kiss and Scat trapped in along the inside, A Lot of Skirt is next. Just Wicked to the outside, Bonita Cat is second last, and For All the Grands is at the back of the pack early on, and it's Thrilled and Marquis Miss. They are 1-2 through the opening quarter. Family Tree from that outside gate now gets up to third. Kiss and Scat is in fourth, about three lengths off the lead at this point. Put the Blame on Me in the yellow to the outside. Then Ready to Confess, the back of the leading flight. Then there's five lengths farther back to Just Wicked, Bonita Cat, A Lot of Skirt, and For All the Grands trails the field. Opening quarter quick, 23.29. Midway up the back stretch, and Marquis Miss is the new leader from Thrilled alongside in second. Family Tree is next up in third. Kiss and Scat is still in fourth, laying about four lengths off the lead. Put the Blame on Me after that. Then a long way back to Ready to Confess, Just Wicked, A Lot of Skirt, Bonita Cat second last for all the grands is at the back of a strung out field. Around the turn, Marquis Miss and Thrilled 1-2. Family Tree getting a nice stalking trip from third. Now Put the Blame on Me and Ready to Confess are closing in. The back markers are closing in as well. A Lot of Skirt is really flying from the back of the pack with Just Wicked for all the grands too. Top of the stretch, Family Tree, Marquis Miss now as they straighten away for the stretch drive. Put the Blame on Me and Ready to Confess. They come down to the final furlong. Ready to Confess and Family Tree 1-2. Put the Blame on Me to the outside and Marquis Miss. It's Family Tree, Ready to Confess that go on with it. Family Tree on top here, and Family Tree and Florent Drew go on to win the Iowa Oaks from Ready to Confess. Put the Blame on Me and For All the Grands was fourth.
Family Tree, Florent Drew in the saddle for Wayne Catalano, the second choice in the wagering. The familiar silks of the West, they score the victory. The offspring of Smart Strike wins by two, returns $8 even over a racetrack listed as good. Ready to Confess finishes second. Antonio Orlando and Dawn backing Put the Blame on Me finishes third. The 8-5 favorite Thrilled beats One Horse, finishing ninth in Thursday's Iowa Oaks. Now time for the boys on Friday evening, the Iowa Derby.
Off and running. Texas Chrome looking for a kiss. Right there too, American Freedom, as they charge by the stands for the first time. And it's looking for a kiss, and American Freedom, they're going to set a decent pace early on. Texas Chrome going to drop in behind the two pace setters. Then comes Catfish Creek, Hint of Roses to the outside of Colonel Dan at the back of the pack. Looking for a kiss, racing out from the rail, has the lead. American Freedom sits second, and Catfish Creek comes right through an opening on the inside to challenge for that lead. Texas Chrome is in the center of the pack. Colonel Dan, Hint of Roses at the back of the field. Opening quarter, 23.52. On to the back stretch. Looking for a kiss, American Freedom, and Catfish Creek is a close third. Texas Chrome getting a good trip early here, settles down into fourth. Hint of Roses is second last, and Colonel Dan is the trailer. They continue down the back stretch, head to the half mile pole now, and it is Catfish Creek and American Freedom 1-2. Texas Chrome takes third, looking for a kiss, a slip back to fourth. Hint of Roses in fifth, closing in now, just three from the top, and Colonel Dan is the trailer. They slowed it right down to 47.75 for the half around the turn, and American Freedom has put away Catfish Creek, but has a new challenger now in Texas Chrome. And to the outside, Hint of Roses within range in third. They pass the quarter pole and come for home in the Iowa Derby. Texas Chrome and American Freedom are 1-2. Hint of Roses is under a ride in third, and looking for a kiss is fourth, and American Freedom kicks on, but so too does Texas Chrome. American Freedom now draws off. Texas Chrome has floated out wide, but American Freedom is now drawing clear with every stride, and American Freedom and Rafael Bayarano, a convincing winner in the Iowa Derby, wins it under wraps. Texas Chrome, Hint of Roses, looking for a kiss, complete the top four.
American Freedom, who I think might have been about 2.5-1 in the morning line, 3-10 on the betting line for the offspring of Pulpit, Bob Baffert's runner. Very impressive, winning by nearly five with Rafael Bejarano in the saddle. Returns $2.60. Texas Chrome finishes second. Hint of Roses finishes third. All right, on to Saturday evening, the race that used to be run at Exarban. I think 1 year, 1985, might have been the only race Gate Dancer won, the Cornhusker.
Off and running. Smack, smack from the inside came out well. Hawakam is right there too. Code West, they all flank out here. And Cyrus Alexander to the extreme outside. Smarvelous is there too as they go under the wire with a lap to go. It's Smarvelous now on top. Cyrus Alexander to the outside. Shotgun Cowboy comes right through along the inside as they sort themselves out now. Then Code West in the gold dives to the inside. As Smack, Smack right there. Eaton Ridge is after that. Followed next by Domain's Wrap. Second last is Hawakam, and one right at the back is Pain and Misery. So they go around the first turn in the Prairie Meadows Cornhusker Handicap, and it's Shotgun Cowboy for Louis Canotis, leads him onto the back stretch and is slowing the pace right down. Smarvelous sits second. Cyrus Alexander to the outside third, a length off the lead. Code West is next. Smack Smack is right in between runners there. Eaton Ridge three wide as they go down the back stretch. Then Domain's Wrap, Pain and Misery, and Hawakam is at the back of a compact Cornhusker field. Half mile left to go. Smarvelous now in the middle. Cyrus Alexander to the outside. Shotgun Cowboy is still there. In fact, pokes ahead get on top now. Code West comes right through along the inside. Gonna need an opening there. Smack, smack in the middle. Eaton Ridge to the outside. Pain and Misery is passing the back markers. Domain's Wrap is second last, and Hawakam is trailing the field. They kick on for home now. Cyrus Alexander to the outside of Smovelis. Pain and Misery's in contention. So too is Smack, Smack there as well. Domain's a Wrap. We have a wide open race here in the Cornhusker Handicap. Pain and Misery on the outside, and Smack, Smack is right there too. Smovelis is there. Shotgun Cowboy. Hawakam is even getting into it from the inside. Code West there too. Smack, 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 Pain and Misery. Shotgun Cowboy. Smack, Smack in between horses to win.
Smack, Smack scores the victory for Shane Lavalette. The huge upset at 16-1. Donnie Von Hemmel sends out the winner, wins the three-horse photo finish, returns $34.20. Third choice in the wagering at 5-2, Shotgun Cowboy. Pain and Misery finishes third. Smarvelous, the 2-1 favorite under Florent Giroux, finishes fourth. Gonna take a quick break. When we come back, stakes action from Santa Anita at Belmont Park.
There's nothing like the thrill and excitement of horse racing. And now, the new home for all the best racing and all the top tracks is OTB-TV on Time Warner Cable Channel 1250, delivering each day the best racing across the country and around the world, whether it's Saratoga or Belmont here in New York, Florida's Gulfstream Park, or California's Del Mar and Santa Anita race courses. No other network brings you the grandeur of horse racing like OTB-TV on Time Warner Cable Channel 1250.
Twenty-four hours a day, 7 days a week, OTB-TV is the Capital Region's choice for the most comprehensive and informative coverage of thoroughbred and harness racing. OTB-TV is the only area network delivering a steady viewership, reaching more than 540,000 households throughout the broadcast day and into the evening. Capital OTB's digital presence also plays a tremendous part in getting your message in front of potential customers. With more and more wagering moving to online, CapitalOTB.com can put your message in front of thousands of potential customers 24 hours a day. And with the addition of our new mobile app, new customers will see your message on all their digital devices. To see how affordably you can reach thousands of new customers, contact Capital OTB's Sales and Marketing Department today. You're
unbelievable. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, turning our attention to Santa Anita 3-year-olds in the Affirmed.
Now 1-5, Dancing Candy, 7-2, Dalmore Racing. And off the inside, Curl and Rules very slowly into stride. Beaumarchais and Dancing Candy are the two early leaders from Prince of Arabia, Dalmore, and a couple of lengths to Curl and Rules back last. Out of the stretch, Beaumarchais with the lead. Dancing Candy lets him go a length in front of him with 7/8 left to run. Then comes Dalmore on the inside of Prince of Arabia. And Curl and Rules with the blinkers on, 4 lengths last, 3/4 of a mile from home. And the leader is Beaumarchais. In second position, Dancing Candy, new trainer, new jockey, new style. Dalmore 2 lengths back, 3rd from Prince of Arabia, 4 lengths to Curl and Rules. Past the 5/8 pole, Beaumarchais a neck in front. Dancing Candy in second position, a gap of 3 lengths to Dalmore, racing well clear of Prince of Arabia. And Curl and Rules remains 5th and last with a 1/2 mile to go in the Affirmed. 9 lengths covering the field of 5, and it's Beaumarchais in the front, 1/2 length from Dancing Candy. 3 lengths to the homebody Dalmore, seeking his 3rd consecutive win at Santa Anita, and he is picking up ground stylishly on those two front runners. Dalmore coming with a big run 3 wide as Dancing Candy heads off Beaumarchais at the quarter pole, and it's Dancing Candy a 1/2 length to Dalmore, about 2 to Beaumarchais, dropping out well under the whip, and then Prince of Arabia, and Curl and Rules has not fired a shot. Less than 3/16 to go. Dalmore right up alongside of Dancing Candy. Dalmore and Dancing Candy in a stirring struggle in the Affirmed Stakes. Dalmore on the out side ahead in front of Dancing Candy. Dalmore coming away. Dalmore will beat Dancing Candy a 1/2 length. 7 clear of Prince of Arabia.
Second choice in the wagering sent out by the DeSormo brothers. They score the half-length upset victory, returning $9.20 for the offspring of Colonel John. Now in the Bob Baffert barn at 1-5. Danzig Candy, well in front of the third place finisher, but unfortunately, half a length behind the winner, Prince of Arabia, finishes third. Okay, now coming back east, three to bring you over the weekend from Belmont Park, two of them on Saturday. Up first, the Perfect Sting.
They're all in line, ready for the start. They're off in the Perfect Sting. Onus had a good start. Neck of the Moon, Old Harbor, and Mississippi Delta right there, too. And then Note to Doro and My Sweet Girl. So Onus gets some early heat from Old Harbor on the outside, and the two of them will go at it, and they appear to be going at a leisurely gallop early on. Neck of the Moon is two lengths off of them, and then Mississippi Delta to the inside, followed by My Sweet Girl, and the trailer up the backstretch is Note to Doro, five lengths behind as they continue their journey up the backstretch. Old Harbor's going to go on with it here on a quarter and 24 and two-fifth seconds as Jose Ortiz takes hold of Onus to sit second up the backstretch and about two lengths off of this front runner. Then Note to Doro inside of Mississippi Delta. Neck of the Moon is just to the outside of them. My Sweet Girl last of the six and six lengths off of Old Harbor. A 28-1 long shot who heads them into the turn on top. Ran a half mile in 49 and one-fifth seconds, but Onus is moving now. She's only three-quarters of a length behind and heading after Old Harbor on the far turn. And then it's Neck of the Moon, Mississippi Delta, and down on their inside is Note to Doro, My Sweet Girl, trails the field. Onus draws even. Onus puts ahead in front here. Old Harbor on the inside counters, and they'll turn for home together. Neck of the Moon is right to the outside of them. And down toward the inside is Mississippi Delta, along with Note to Doro and My Sweet Girl on the far outside. And Neck of the Moon's taking the lead. Neck of the Moon in front. Onus will have to do her best to stick with her. My Sweet Girl is next on the outside, and then Mississippi Delta. It's Neck of the Moon in front. My Sweet Girl running a big one, a late bid. Here's the wire. She got there. My Sweet Girl runs down Neck of the Moon, and then it was Onus and Mississippi Delta in a final time of 1 minute 35.75 seconds.
My Sweet Girl over a yielding turf course goes from last to first to score the upset victory as the second longest shot on the board for Barkley Tag and Manny Franco. They win the photo finish, returning $31.60. Neck of the Moon, second choice in the wagering, finishes second, and the 3-5 favorite, Onus, finishes third. Also on the card Saturday afternoon, one of the premier three-year-old filly races of the year, shortened up to a mile and a 16th for the 2010 renewal, the Mother Goose.
They're off in the Mother Goose. Lewis Bay lunged coming out of the gate. And it will be off the tracks who will take the early lead. And Mom's on Strike's going to go with her. Longshot Linda Mimi is down on the inside. And then comes Rachel's Valentina, who's fourth up the backstretch. Lewis Bay is back there running in fifth position and four lengths off the lead. Then comes Mo D'Amore, and the undefeated filly Lightstream is at the rear of the field as they head up the backstretch. The first quarter was very fast, 22 and three-fifth seconds, and it is off the tracks in front. A neck on top of Mom's on Strike up the backstretch. Rachel's Valentina is right to the outside of Lewis Bay. They are third and fourth now. Linda Mimi is fifth and down on the inside as they race for the far turn. Lightstream and Mo D'Amore are at the rear of the field. The half was 45-2 in the Mother Goose. And off the tracks in, Jose Ortiz continue to lead the way. Pressed along by Mom's on Strike to the outside. Lewis Bay is third and just two lengths off of them. John Velasquez really asking more now from Rachel's Valentina. He is asking for her best run on the far turn, and she's still fourth, and she's going three wide coming to the top of the stretch. Lightstream has floated very wide, and then comes Mo D'Amore. Off the tracks, will turn for home, and the Mother Goose off the tracks in front. Three quarters in 109-3. And Lewis Bay is strong, and she's moving up alongside. Not today for Rachel's Valentina. Lightstream is third with less than a furlong to go. Off the tracks is holding on to the lead. On the outside, it is Lewis Bay, but she's second best. And off the tracks has won the Mother Goose by three lengths under Jose Ortiz. And then came Lewis Bay, followed by Lightstream, Mo D'Amore, and Rachel's Valentina ends up fifth. The final time was 1 minute 41.01 seconds.
A brilliant performance by Off the Tracks, Todd Pletcher, Jose Ortiz, who is going to be a runaway winner of this Belmont Spring Summer Meet. Off the Track sets a new stakes record. Now, remember, this is only the seventh time they run it at a mile and a 16th. But Off the Tracks re-breaks in the stretch to win by 3.5 comfortable lengths. Returns $8.10. Lewis Bay looked to be a real threat in here as the second choice at 2-1 finishes second. Lightstream, who was 3-for-3 at 7 furlongs, finishes third. The 9-5 favorite, Rachel's Valentina, boy, she looked in trouble the entire way, finishes fifth. And on Independence Day, we ran the third running of the Manila.
They're off in the Manila. Two Discreet broke well, and so did Giant Run, and these two go right at it from the beginning. Strike Midnight is away running in third on the outside, and Rappel is fourth and down toward the hedge. Then comes Dig Deep. Fifth up the backstretch and 5.5 lengths off the lead. Life Imitates Art right next to him. Conquest Sia is trailing the field behind the grade two Discreet. And Joel Rosario, and they're in front through a 22.4 opening quarter mile. Smoking right along here on the lead is two Discreet. Joel Rosario trying to restrain this speed of his, but he's running off to a length and three quarters advantage. Giant Run is running in second. Rappel is third to the inside. Then it's Strike Midnight in fourth, just to the outside of Life Imitates Art, who's fifth, 5 lengths from the front. Dig Deep and Conquest Sia. The half is up in 45.4. Around the far turn, it is two Discreet out there in front by a length. Giant Run is second, Rappel third to the inside, saving all the ground. And just in behind the leaders, Longshot Rappel just inside the pacemaker here as they come toward the top of the stretch. Strike Midnight is next. Dig Deep swings up on the far outside, and they're into the stretch. And now it's Giant Run. Giant Run has taken the lead from two Discreet. Strike Midnight is right there. Rappel's running a big one in behind horses, and now comes through an opening on the inside. Life Imitates Art's trying to make a late rally. It is Giant Run in front to the outside. Strike Midnight. These two 1-2 now, and Giant Run and John Velasquez wins another here today by 2 under the wire to Strike Midnight. Then it was Rappel and Life Imitates Art. The final time on the board was 1 minute 32.85 seconds.
John Velasquez, who had a great day. I forget exactly how many, but I think this was his fourth on the day. Giant Run wins by a length and a half with the big run in there. Boy, no rails were up, boy, at 132.85 for this listed stakes race, boy. A fantastic performance for $16 for Tom Albertrani, the offspring of Giants Causeway. Strike Midnight finishes second, and by far the longest shot on the board, the only horse above 9-1 at 24-1, Rappel runs brilliantly to finish third. The 3-1 favorite, Life Imitates Art, finishes fourth. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that wraps up this week's edition of HNC. Enjoy your stakes action from around the country, and join us next time for Horses and Courses.
You're watching OTB TV, a service of Capital Off Track Betting.